So let's talk about three of the best ways to measure brain activity. Starting with the electroencephalography. This is commonly called an EEG. It records electrical activity of the brain through electrodes placed on the scalp. This technique is really good at showing general activity of the brain, but it's not terribly precise at showing where exactly the activity is occurring. This is what a typical one would look like. Next, we have the positron emission tomography, or PET scan for short. This measures blood flow to brain areas that are activated, because neural response requires blood. This technology requires a person to ingest a harmless radioactive form of oxygen or glucose. The radioactive level in the oxygen is picked up by the scanning device during brain activity. Computers then color code the most active areas in red, somewhat active areas in yellow, and the least active areas in blue and green, like you see here. And finally, we have the functional magnetic resonance imaging, or fMRI for short. This also measures blood flow to active brain regions, but it doesn't use radioactive forms of oxygen. Instead, the fMRI uses magnetic fields to detect regions of the brain that are activated. One advantage of this is that it can give us a very precise picture of which part of the brain is active. This is what a typical fMRI machine looks like. Now, it's really important to point out that none of these techniques directly measure neural activity. They all measure it indirectly. There are ways of measuring individual neurons, but because it involves surgery, it's almost never used on humans. I know there's a lot of information about the brain structure, so if you need to, you can go over some of the parts of the lesson again, or always go back to the document we gave you.